No, I'm going over there.
Good morning, saints. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen, amen. So we stand. The reading of the word.
Thank you.
And we're at the same time. This is holy ground. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Where the believers are, the believers gathered together to worship, we are standing on holy ground.
Amen.
So put everything of the world out of your mind this morning. But we could move forward into His presence with all our heart and with all our mind. I'm going to be reading from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 20. Jeremiah, chapter 20, verses 5. True love. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. And the word of God says, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I will also give over all the wealth of this city, all its produce and its costly things, even all the treasures of the kings of Judah, I will give over to the land, to the hand of their enemies, and they will plunder them, take them away and bring them to Babylon. 6. And you, Pheshur, and all who live in your house will go into captivity, and you will enter Babylon, and there you will die, and there you will be buried, and all your friends to whom you have falsely prophesied. 7. O Lord, you have deceived me, and I was deceived. You have overcome me and prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all day long. Everyone mocks me. 8. For each time I speak, I cry out. I cry aloud. I proclaim violence and destruction, because for me the word of the Lord has resulted in reproach and disorientation all day long. But if I say I will not remember him or speak any more of his name, then in my heart it becomes like a burning fire. Amen. And verse 10. For I, it continues on in this one. Shut up in my bones, and I am weary of holding it in, and I cannot endure it. 10. For I have heard the whispering of many terrors of every side. Denounce him. Yes, let us denounce him. All my trusted friends, watch, for all may fall saved. Perhaps he will be deceived so that he may prevail against him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me, a dread champion. Therefore, my persecutors will stumble and will not prevail. They will be utterly ashamed because they have failed, with an everlasting disgrace that will not be forgotten. Oh, praise the Lord. That is a mouthful. But all in all, what it's saying is those that are with the Lord, He will not let down. Those that are with the Lord, He will be their power and their strength throughout. Those that lie against, their life will show the truth. How we walk and how we talk will show the truth. Those that scheme against us will fail in their schemes as we hold true to Him. We have a fire in us that the Lord wants us to bring out this morning. Let that fire be lit. Let us come before His throne. So we bow our head and ask Him to move in a mighty way today. Father, we come before You, Lord. We're asking You, Lord, to stir up our hearts, O Lord, no matter what's happening all around us, O Lord, no matter how things fail us, Lord. We know that You are the answer, and You are the power, and You are the fire in our hearts, O Lord. Lord, have us, O Lord. Fill us, O Lord, with the right words and the right witness to say, Lord. No matter what comes into our lives, Lord, You are fast. You are firm, O Lord. Lord, we can't help but witness, O Lord, what You have done. You have saved us from death, O Lord, because You want to, Lord. You have healed our sickness, O Lord, because You want to, Lord. And because You love us with all Your heart. the saints of old, Lord, as the prophets of old, Lord. Holy Ghost, by faith and with your Spirit, moves on them, Lord. But Lord, you have promised each and every one of us that you are with us always, Lord. We are never alone, Lord. That you stand by us. You undergird us, O Lord. You lift us up above our troubles, O Lord. And Father, you are our shield. You walk us through the trials, O Lord. And the victory is yours. The battle is yours, Lord. This morning, Lord, relieve us of our burden. Break every chain that holds us back to worship you this morning, O Lord. Father, receive our love and receive our worship this morning as we come forward, O Lord, to praise your holy name. Father, bless your children in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Come on, let's come and praise you, Lord.
Thank you. exalt you, Jesus.
Around them, oh Lord. Let them feel, oh Lord, your love and your compassion, Lord.
Lord. Father, there is nothing impossible for you, Lord. Lord, we give you honor right now, Lord. Stir our hearts and let that fire grow and grow in us, O Lord. Let there be a revival in all our hearts, Lord. Those that are exposed, those that are hurting, O Lord, let the fire burn and know that you are God. Touch them, O Lord, and let them know, Lord, that you want them to love you with all their hearts. As you have loved them through your Son, O Lord, and through your heart, Father. Father, let us, O Lord, see your hand move this morning in such a special way, Lord. Thank you for moving upon us now, Lord, and stirring our hearts, O Lord. And Lord, I ask you right now, hear our hearts, O Lord. Even the words we don't say, Lord, but you sense them and we know them. Father, we ask now, bless and anoint your children. Bless and anoint all those that seek you, Lord. Give them peace in their heart this morning as we draw closer to you. We ask it all in the blessed name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Out of your comfort zone and just go see him and somebody. Take a minute and just five seconds. Good to see you. Yeah. Yeah. Things didn't work out, you know.
Something came into my heart and I just want to share it. You know, no matter what enemy is out there or what creature the devil can manifest, God's power is the most powerful thing. And you might need to know that. There might be someone sitting here that needs to know that today. God's power, the Holy Spirit, is the most powerful thing in the whole world.
Amen.
Somebody needs to know that. And as you make your way to your seats, and I love that we have a full house today. Thank you all. We're just starting to get out right in the house of the Lord. Amen. I just want to remind you too that, you know, we're not up here just singing. We are worshiping. And when you're worshiping the Lord and everybody comes to one accord, God meets you down here. That's why it was special today. But if you start every day worshiping the Lord before you start your day, just think of every day how blessed you're going to be. You're going to have God's presence with you all the time. I believe that if you worship him, it has to come from your heart. See, he met us here today. Amen. If you didn't feel his spirit, I mean, he was here. He was here. Amen. Amen. And if you don't know where to sing some of the songs or worship or listen to some of the songs, you know, go on the, you know, Pandora and look for gospel music, you know. You go on the internet for other stuff. You know, go on for, you know, worship songs. A lot of those songs, they play on there and we sing them here. So, you know, I want to encourage you, if you don't know a radio station, you know, I'm not plugging a radio station, but 103.5, you know, that's Christian music. So, you know, if you want to, you know, learn some of these songs, then, you know, wake up every day with that music on your radio and go on to work or whatever, you know, let it encourage you, you know, that God is with you always, and believe and trust, okay? Amen. I believe he had, he told me to say that. I'm just being obedient because, you know, this can't be a Sunday thing. This has to be an everyday thing. It's not Sunday and Wednesday. You got to live this life every day. You know, every day. It's you know, if you don't change, you know, when he comes and that door is not open for you, you know, you can't blame nobody but yourself. Do you know what I'm saying? You can't blame nobody but yourself. You got to look to the Lord because he is there for you. He's there every day. Every day. Push forward every day. Trust in him because he takes care of your house and he takes care of our house. And on that note, there's a textable number in case you are on vacation somewhere. You can still get your offering. Come on down. Thank you, Lord. It's time to receive the Lord's tithe and offering. We can get it coming to the Lord again. He's been so good to us. I know there were some people out on vacation. You know, if you tithe, you know the Lord, he takes care of you, so you can enjoy your time. But it's so, I'm so glad you're all back. Amen. God is good. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, thank you, Lord. Come on, remember.
My back's heavy now.
You didn't even start in this heavy already. That's a good sign. Amen. Amen. Oh, thank you, Lord, for bringing us here today, Lord. Thank you for all of your blessings. He says, trust in me.
Yes.
And I will give you the desires of your heart. But you have to put him first. You have to give him your first fruit. And he will provide everything that you need. But you need to trust in him. I pray that this offering meets all of the needs at your house and city limits, Lord. And out there, because we do help other missionaries out there. So they can send your word out. So they can speak your word. But we need to be faithful. Okay? And take care of your house. Lord, I pray that that this offering just blesses your house. And if there is anyone out there that needs a job, Lord, I pray right now that you just provide that job so he can take care of, or she can take care of, their house and your house. Lord, I pray blessings over this offering. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Sorry, I get a little excited up here because the Lord is good. Amen.
90.
Hi, ladies. I have some announcements for you, for all of you, for the women. Just a reminder, I'm going to get paperwork to you guys next week so you can see. You can't hear me? Can you hear me in the back? Can you hear me? No, maybe she can't. All right, I'll just keep talking and somebody will be able to hear me. In November, we have our conference in Hershey. It's the Celebrate Conference. I just put this morning on my Facebook page, I know friends, a lot of you, not everybody, but a lot of you have friends or have friended me on Facebook. I put the link for the Pendel Women of Purpose for you to register. That is $60, $35 for single moms, for seniors, and for students up to 22. Need to register, I think, by the end of October. And we also need to start looking around and deciding who you want your roommates to be if you're going. We go Thursday to a Saturday. It's November, I believe, 10th to the 12th. My brain just... 10th to the 12th. And we go Thursday to Saturday. The room total cost is $305. So it's around, it's $77 if you stay in a room with four ladies. So you want to start looking around to see who could your roommate be, start asking around and getting that settled in so we can start reserving rooms. There's already a hold for us. All you need to do is call and I'll give that information to you. And you ask for the city limits room block and you hold it on a credit card, but you don't have to pay till you actually get there. So just like you would if you went on vacation, you hold it and then when you get there, you pay for it. All right, and so I'll get specific details instead of me just announcing it, because I know I need it written down. I'm not real good with just oral directions. So I'll write that down for you for next week. All right, the other thing is, is next tomorrow. Tomorrow we are meeting. Everyone say next tomorrow. Tomorrow we are meeting for our second class on pulling back the shades. We met 2 weeks ago on this book, and it's so much more than just this book. I know there's some new faces here, so I'm just going to kind of do a quick plug. This is written by Donna Brush and Julie Slattery, and at the beginning it was a response to 50 Shades of Grey and erotica, but there's so much more in here. It's not just that. It's about being sexually pure. It's about being pure as women in our minds, how, you know, men are very visual. Men see stuff, and that might be what attracts them, and it can pull them astray. But we have things in our mind. How many ladies have gone on, like, their first date, and you already have yourself married with children and on your honeymoon? Like, women are like that. We're like, I think he's the perfect one. And you have just met him, and you're having your first conversation. But in our mind, we'll have ourselves, we're married, we've got children, we're on, like, our honeymoon, we've already got, you know, the house with 2.5 kids and a dog. So women are like that. We will play it out in our head somewhere and never even going to go. So now think about us as women. That is where our battle is. Our battle is really mental. It's fantasy. It's what we think. It's what we might be having some struggles with. Now, if you're sitting there, ladies, and you're like, that doesn't kind of have that struggle at all. I don't really think about sex in that way or a struggle. Then, okay, then this class is not for you. But, yeah, don't come. If you don't have these struggles, It's not going to be a good fit, and you're going to just sit there and maybe even feel frustrated. But if you know that you have had some struggles, maybe in the past or even in your future, like it's affecting you now, it will affect your future, is what I'm saying. Then do come. If you think it's something that you have struggled in relationships and that, you know, you have struggles fantasizing, if you have read erotica whose sole purpose is to arouse you sexually. So there's a lot of books out there, and that's its sole purpose. It's a romance novel seeking sex, is basically all it is. So if that's you, please meet me tomorrow in the Hallabria at 6:30. 6:30 to 8, don't need to bring food, bring your own coffee. Where's Trill? We're gonna bring our own coffee, buddy, okay? He always makes us coffee, and then I feel so bad because we don't drink it. And I'm like, well, thanks for making it, I'm sorry. So bring your own coffee. We don't have to bring any snacks or anything. Now, we have read up to chapter 3 for tomorrow. So if you have not read it, you don't have the book, I can get you a free copy of the PDF. So if you email, I can email that to you, and you can print it out, or you can read it right on your device. Most of you that have books, if you haven't read up to 3, that's okay. I'm going to kind of go through some of it, but I want to make it more of a discussion. Last time it was more me talking and going over some stuff. I want to make it a discussion. If you are not going to go, could you just pray for us? And just keep us in your prayers, because this is a touchy subject. It's a difficult subject. I know there's some of you that have already told me that you're praying for us. And I know I'm spending a lot of time on this, but it's important. And the purpose, what should you pray for? For women to be set free. For this not to be like a gossip fest. I don't want that. If you're going to come in and gossip about other people, don't come. I want this to be about you getting free for you. You talking about your struggles and you getting free for you. Your mind, your heart, and that you can be whole and have victory in Christ. And that's really what the purpose is. And so pray for us, because as we delve into this subject that is touchy, you know, if we don't talk about this in the church, we're going to get our ideals and we're going to get our thoughts from the world. And I want to talk about this and go kind of into some waters we don't always go into, because I want us to be free as women of God and walk in purity and not in shame and have our heads held high, because we know that we are daughters of the Most High God. So tomorrow, 6:30. This is the last plug I'll be making for it from this point on, so this is the last time. So if you're interested, please come out, because after tomorrow, we're going to be on chapter 4. We'll be halfway through the book, and you will have missed, you know, you will have missed too much. So if you're interested, come tomorrow.
Brothers and sisters, how many of you attended a Thrive discipleship class? Raise your hand. Okay. Well, since it's the first time that we've offered that class, Pastor Jim asked that we do an evaluation to make it better, to see what was good, to see what we could improve. So in the next week, your teachers will be giving you an evaluation form, regardless of where you are in the course, if you're done, if you're halfway done. and we want to get your feedback, okay? So please fill that out right away, and if you would return it to me at one of the services, I'd like them back by Labor Day so that we can compile them and give them back to the teachers, okay? Amen. Thanks so much. God bless you.
Amen. I'm going to release the children to children's church. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, okay. We're going to be entertained. Amen. Something special. Kids, hang on. I understand that we're going to have something special. Okay, real quick. Nursery is open for those that have babies. It's open so you can take your child down there. All right? And you know this is the kids. One note is for children's church. Only the teams that have asked for help should go up. But other teams should stay here and not apply during pastor's sermon. Amen. Okay, Pastor.
Not just, I know that you're going to bring the children up. Jen, I want to say to you and to all the other teachers and the men, it was just so good to see. You know, I came on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I was sitting upstairs, and Thursday I had a meeting, but then I came back on Friday, and it was so good to see how many had started from the beginning, and it came almost to about 100 kids, 78 by Friday. I just personally want to thank you. You know, I don't have a card or a text way to send that to you. I have Christmas cards from 1958 that are in the attic that I'm about to send out, and they're too late. I don't even know those people anymore. And so you understand, you know, that I'm not good with that. But I just want to take a minute and say thank you so much for all your hard work. And I saw you here. I saw you under some of the conditions were just tough. You know, you were in hot rooms and all the public ministries and everything and the setting up, and people stayed until 3 a.m. and they did the vacuum the floors and they shampooed them, and just thank you so much for your investment in our children. It meant so much to me. I got to watch and just to sit back and watch, and it just blessed my heart. And so if I have not told you yet, I want to just say thank you so much. And it's so wonderful to see a full house today.
I really don't have much more to say after that, but I would also like to extend a thank you to everybody who came out this week. Without you, we would have had no BTS. So if all the crew station leaders, if you guys would also come up with the kitties and stand up here so we can do those songs, it'd be greatly appreciated. All my friends who came to VBS, if you would please join us and then face them, I'll be down there.
Come on, don't be shy.
Thank you. Yeah. other churches down this list. Is there any bass there for me? Maybe you sound like a new all around. Is there an echo?